In this particular video, I'm talking about goose grass or Eleusine indica. It is known as wire grass or crowfoot grass. It is common, very common weed with several health benefits for poultry and livestock animals. It contains various biotic compounds, including antioxidant, essential amino acids, and micronutrients, which contribute to its value as a natural feed supplement. Here are some of the health benefits to poultry and livestock animals. One is digestive support. Goose grass has mild laxative properties that help maintain a healthy digestive system and prevent constipation in livestock. It aids in gut motility, ensuring proper nutrient absorption. It is very rich in nutrients. It contains essential nutrients like calcium, magnesium, and potassium, which contribute to bone development and metabolic processes in poultry and livestock animals. It has antimicrobial properties. Goose grass possesses natural antimicrobial compounds that can help prevent infections in digestive and respiratory tracts of animals, poultry, and four-legged animals. It has anti-inflammatory effects. The HAP biotics compound reduces inflammation, which can support recovery from injuries or stress in animals. Mostly, if you are a broiler farmer and during the heat period, your broiler is panicking, they are finding it difficult to breathe because of heat, you can use this particular plant. It helps to energize them and at the same time, help them to recover from stress. It boosts immunity. That is one of the best benefits of this particular grass. The antioxidant in goose grass enhances the immunity system. It protects animals from diseases caused by oxidative stress. It promotes weight gain. If you're a broiler farmer, this particular plant should be your friend. As a green forage, it provides energy and protein that support growth and weight gain, particularly in poultry and small ruminants, especially broilers. Very good for broiler farming, especially if you want to sell your broiler in 6 weeks. Use this particular grass. It improves egg production. If you are into egg layer, either ASAP Brown or Red Island or any other massive egg laying birds. For poultry, incorporating goose grass in feed, it will improve their nutrient diversity, which leads to better egg production and egg quality. It strengthens the eggshell and makes it very strong so that the crack and the loss due to crack will reduce. It has anti-dewormer. A natural dewormer from this goose grass can help reduce intestinal parasites, naturally minimizing reliance on chemical dewormers. That money you spend in buying synthetic dewormers, you will invest it into their feed. It supports wound healing. When applied externally, goose grass is traditionally used to treat wound and skin infections in livestock or four-legged animals due to its antimicrobial and soothing properties. In fact, I used this goose grass. My dog had an injury 2 days ago. I used it on them. Today, the whole thing is off. The wound is healed completely. It is environmentally friendly and has a lot of environmental benefits. Feeding goose grass to livestock can help manage weed on farm, providing dual benefit for feed and weed control. Now, what are the diseases, the common diseases and infections or health issues this goose grass can handle before we go to how to use them? One is goose grass is used in herbal remedies and is known for its medicinal properties that can address specific infections and diseases in poultry and livestock. Here are 5 notable infections and diseases that can help manage or cure. One is coccidiosis. 2 is respiratory infection, CRUD. 3 is intestinal worm infestation. And 4, salmonellosis. And 5, wound infections and skin diseases. It can handle all these effectively well. Now, for coccidiosis, goose grass contains biotic compounds with anti-inflammatory and antimicrobial properties that help control intestinal damage caused by Eleusine parasite. They benefit because it supports recovery of gut health and improves digestion and reduces mortality in poultry. You can see that's how it can handle coccidiosis. Now, respiratory. Because of antimicrobial compounds in goose grass, it can help combat bacterial and fungal infections affecting the respiratory system, such as chronic respiratory diseases, CRD. The benefit is that it reduces symptoms like wheezing, nasal discharge, eye discharge, discharge, and poor feed intake that affects the growth of the animals. Intestinal wall infections. Goose grass acts as a natural dewormer due to its mild antimicrobial properties. The benefit is that it eliminates intestinal parasites like roundworm, hookworm, including feed that is affected by worm. It also helps in food efficiency and overall health. It helps in salmonellosis and wound healing. Apply it externally to injuries in poultry and livestock animals. Squeeze the water out and apply it on that injury. Within 3 days, it will clear off. Mostly, if you have broilers or turkey have what you call fowl paws or turkey paws, any of these injuries, just scrape them. Use something and scrape them and apply the water on those injuries. It will just clear off within 3 to 4 days. Now, how do you use this goose grass? You can use it as fresh, you can use it as air dried, and you can use it as boiled. Now, for fresh, what do you do? This grass is stubborn. If you see cow, if the cows are moving in line, even with the herdsmen coming after them, once they see this grass, they will stop and make sure they eat this grass before they go, because they know the benefit this grass has for them and for their life. That's why they don't play with it. As small and as tiny as this grass is, for you, it means nothing. You're asking yourself, what is this calf? What did they see in this particular grass? They will bend down as height as their height is. They will come low to pluck this grass from the ground to tell you that this grass, they know that it has a lot of medicinal and health benefit for them. So that is why you know that these animals know what is good for them. As you, as a human being, you know the food that is good for you also. That's why it is for them also. So pluck out the whole grass from the ground. It has a lot of roots. Wash the grass together with the roots. Chop them for direct feeding. Slice them and mix with their feed. That's one. If you have threshing machine, use the machine and grind it together with and mix it with their feed and give to them. Now, you can also gather the enough quantity of this grass. Wash them in a clean water. If you have a stream around you, wash it in a clean so that it will be very neat. Spray it so that the water will dry off and air dry it. After air drying it, grind it to powder and mix with the feed also. And that one is boil. Wash it as it is, the quantity you need. After washing, put it in a very good pot and boil it up to 30 minutes. Depending on the type of fire, you are using firewood, you are using gas, I don't know. But boil it so that the liquid will come out. Allow it to cool. After getting cold, use the water and feed to your livestock animals into their drinking water. Please, for the application and dosage, tell me the particular animal. Here I'm talking about livestock farm animals, four-legged and feathered animals. That is chicken, goose, dog, guinea fowl, and rest of them. Goat, cow, cattle, and rest of them. Tell me the particular animal you are rearing, and I will give you the way you are going to apply it. What I need from you on the comment section is, this is the particular animal, this is the age. This is broiler age. Is it day old, growers, or finisher? Tell me, is it layers, chicks, growers, or laying birds? I will tell you how to apply it, their dosage. Please, so that you not overuse them. If you use it, it has anti-medicinal properties also. So you don't need to overuse it, please. On the comment section, let's meet there and finish the rest. So that this video will not be too long. For now, I say bye. Till I come with another interesting topic loading very soon. Drop your comment, share the video, subscribe if this is your first time of coming across this video. And all my subscribers and viewers, wherever you are in any part of the world, I say may God continue to bless you, see you this season, and bless your handwork. For now, bye.